In today's Google Maps citation video, I want to share with you the right way to do Google Maps citations, the wrong way of Google Maps citations, and how I know what's right and wrong. And also, I want to share with you how business owners are getting these two things confused. So my name is Chris Palmer. Let's not waste any time. Let's get directly into the information. So first and foremost, there's a massive difference between Google Maps citations and citations for Google, all right? Now, here's a list here, top 50 citations in the United States. These are your regular citations for your business, okay? So that's one thing. Now, your My Maps or Google Maps citations are these particular types of citations that are created utilizing My Maps. Now, as you can see, there are hundreds and hundreds and thousands of customers, business owners, just like you, buying these services, and you're actually doing yourself a disservice. There's a reason why the cost is so low, because there's automated tools to create these massive circles like this, and the value is not in having the depth, all right? As you can see here, I went in here and just did this really fast for this video. You make your original step, you make your original My Map, okay? This is a Google Maps citation. You then create layers, much like I did here. So let's zoom into here. I want to share this with you really briefly here. You then create the layers, okay? Now, as I create more pins, look at, there's one, two, three layers, you're going down. This is how they're making that circular effect. They're creating depth and relevance. But how I want to share with you how you know this is wrong and the value is not creating depth. It's by creating multiple My Maps based on a keyword. And the reason I know that this type of service is wrong, not only do I know from testing that it doesn't push any power, but I also know because Google does not see all of that depth. Google doesn't see how many of these you put in. They're only counting the one for one keyword. So the power isn't creating depth. The power is by creating one on a variation or a primary keyword. Let me give you an example. If I'm searching for whatever I'm searching for, let's just say it's Duke lost and found locations, okay? And then I'll just to make it faster, I'll put My Maps in there. Now, as you can see here, when it gets listed inside of Google, when Google indexes it, they index it and give credit based on one keyword. And it's not just any willy-nilly keyword, it's the one that you made the actual map on. As you can see here, Duke lost and found locations. Look at all this depth that they added. None of this is accredited. It's based off the main map title and what you made that map on, okay? Let me give you another example. If we were to go to 50 states backpacking project. Let's just take a look at this. 50 states backpacking project. I'm gonna do Control F, Google Maps. Oh, let's type that in here. Okay, let's just take a look here. So again, 50 states backpacking project. When I go over to it, there's depth here. It talks about it in other states, but it's only giving credit based on the actual title. So let's break these down. How do I know that making them not very big depth, making them large, like making one large is wrong? How do I know that's wrong? Because Google only index it on one keyword that's inside of the title, all right? So in creating these very large, highly in-depth for $5, the value is only based on the one keyword that you put up here for the name of the map. It's 50 states backpacking project. Whatever the title of the main map, that's how you're getting the credit. And how do I know this? Because when you go on Google, you're only getting credit for the keyword that's in the main map. Aside from this, when business owners are getting it misinterpreting the Google Maps, just like here, if you take a look at this, I did Google Maps citations. You have all these types, but then you'll have somebody, and I don't know who this is, but it looks like they're doing a good job. They have 1,200 live Google Maps citations. If you read inside of here, you can see that they're actually doing 200 actual citations, not the pins. All right. So the meaning of this video is Google Maps citations. What's the right way to do them? What's the wrong way to do them? How do I know? And how are customers interpreting it wrongly? That's what I've covered in today's video. I hope that this helps you out. If you're gonna do the My Maps citations, the Google My Maps citations, create one. Don't go after big, broad keywords. Go after your long tail keywords. These My Maps get indexed. These My Maps pass power. These My Maps are still relevant in 2021, but it's only based off of one keyword. Don't just put SEO in here and think you're gonna get it to rank, but if you do a long tail phrase keyword that only has 10 volume, the chances of you getting it in there are pretty high. My name's Chris Palmer. If you have any other questions related to Google Maps, Google Maps citations, Google citations, or just citations, anything, feel free, go ahead, ask me in the comments, and I always look forward to seeing you in the next Google Maps citations video. I'll see you in the next one.